Banking and Finance Awards highlight the innovation, achievement, strategy, progressive and inspirational changes taking place within the global financial community. The awards were created to recognize companies of all sizes who excelled in particular areas of expertise and excellence within the global financial community. This time, we're pleased to offer an award to Sucor Asset Management. Based in Jakarta, Indonesia, Sucorinvest Asset Management have 28 years of experience in equity brokerage, fixed income trading, investment banking and research. Sucor Asset Management was established in 1997. It's been transformed into a boutique asset management service that serves clients' niche investment objectives and risk profiles through a broad range of tailor-made investment capabilities. Sucor has vast experience and a reputation in asset management, which has led to rapid growth, with an asset under management of more than $446.22 million by the middle of 2018. Today, we're glad to present an award for Best Asset Management Company Indonesia 2019. Recently, we welcomed Jemmy Paul Wawointana, Chief Executive Officer of Sucorinvest Asset Management, to London to receive the award and tell us more about the company.
Well, welcome to London. Thank you so much for coming today and congratulations on the award as well.
Well, thank you so much. We are very honored to get the award actually, because it is like the first time in Europe we get the award. So we are very honored for us, especially if you invite us to come here and also do this interview.
Well, let's talk more about your organization, Sucorinvest Asset Management. How was it actually established and how has it developed over the years?
Well, we established in 1997, so we are 22 years helping people in Indonesia to invest. And of course, we are very happy to be one of the leading asset managers in Indonesia. Currently, we manage around almost 7 trillion rupiah or around 360 million pounds, which is growing a lot. Like in the last 3 years, we are managing more and more people. So our investor is growing multiple, like thousands percent of investor coming in and investing in our companies.
This is wonderful news, because I know that you have had a very strong growth in AUM, yeah, or asset under management. Tell us how that happened. What do you attribute to the success, would you say?
Yeah, like you said before, in our recent conversation, that we are growing a lot in our fund return, like almost 100% across among for these 3 years, and we get a lot of investor invest in our funds. It's because of in 2015 actually we are rebuilding our investment philosophy. So we are not just purely do the value investing method, but the approach also we combine it with the sector rotation. So like we see which sectors will outperform the market, and also we also see the market cycle. It's not just the business cycle. So that's why we can get more and more alpha to our investors.
Now, what about those investors? You mentioned them there. What are the current opportunities, would you say, that there are for investors in your country at the moment?
Yeah, because currently we are facing a president election. And over the years, if you see the historical itself from 1990s, we got strong growth, like 30% average every time the election over. Like in the next 6 months, the growth in the index for the equity market is going up a lot. So I think this is the opportunity for investor to come and invest in Indonesia. Actually, for Indonesian, we always strive to find more and more return. So I think 30%, which is people think a lot in Indonesia, sometimes they think, wow, that's not that much, the kind investing they want, right?
But the market itself is very volatile, isn't it? I mean, not just in your country, but internationally. What advice do you actually give your clients to ride out that situation?
Yeah, so we're advising our client not to be very cautious about it, because if you try to beat the market by trading the funds or the stock they want and do it in the volatile market, sometimes they cannot beat the market. So they just stick with us, because over the years, if you see our past performance, last 5 years, we always beat the index. And if they think that they can trust us fully, then they will get a higher return from investing in us. But of course, beyond the opportunity I told you before about the presidential election and the result after this, the return of our equity index, we also cautious about the European and America economic slowing down. So we also make some information to our clients. We produce some material like research and etc. So we can make them more safe, feel safer because of investing in us.
I see what you mean. You're saying obviously the world finance actually has a big effect on what happens in your country as well, yeah, in Indonesia. And do you actually have any tailor-made solutions to help clients?
Yeah, actually we have many products. We have equity, balance fund, money market. We also have a fixed income. And all of our my RMs, marketing manager, they try to fit with the client needs. For example, the liabilities they need to fulfill to match in their investing. So they will suggest which fund or which class asset class they have to invest, and about the risk opportunity they could have in the next 3 or 5 years, or maybe they only want to invest for 1 year. Then we have our RMs to do that.
Now, just looking in general terms, you know, Indonesia's gone through many challenges recently. Sure. It's made world news, of course. Yeah. How do you actually support the economic development in your country?
Well, we are actively engaging with our investor with social media in Indonesia. We do some event in the large and small cities. We educate the people how about investing in Indonesia. And also we have a fund which is a philanthropy fund that we also contribute to share with the people in Indonesia. We contribute some of our profits from the fund to be invested in some schools by a foundation.
How do you actually promote that and let people know the good work you're doing?
Yeah, actually we are doing social media campaign. Our Instagram followers is, I think, one of the most followed in Indonesia. Our Facebook and also the Twitter, you know, these millennials, they
so social networking, very
important. Social networking, which is very important for us, because I think we might not the largest one in Indonesia, but I think we are one of the largest one in, if you see about the investor itself, the number of investors in Indonesia, because we are quite famous in Indonesia through our social media campaign.
Well, that's good news. Obviously, that's part of the success. What are your other plans for continued success over the forthcoming years and months?
Yeah, of course, we will continue to do our social media campaign. But recently, we contacted with some larger institutional like pension fund and also the insurance, and also we are expanding our distribution channel like bigger banks, like multinational banks, and like this year we might have additional like one or two multinational banks to distribute our fund, which is very good for us. So I think that will support our growth, not just for our investor base, but also our total asset under management.
Well, it looks like a success story, which hopefully will continue to
thank
grow.
So
in the meantime, thank you so much for coming to London.
Thank you.
And talking to us, and congratulations on that award once again.
Thank you once again. Thank you.